So, to begin with, we want to take a nice wide brush. So we just need to do an overall coverage of just about everything. Just going from one side to the other. Just like that. Here I'm working from my left to my right, your right to your left. Just consistent sweep. Well, just a few little downward strokes. Just make sure we get those corners there, and then up. Just like that, and those bottom little corners. That is looking very nice and even. That is good. That is a good starting point. Now I'm going to pop this down. I shouldn't need a brush this size for anything this small in detail. So let me just pop that down. Similar sort of brush, but much smaller. So need to get some separation between the top and bottom there. Of course, and there is more often than not the sky at the halfway down, as you see that, so then just about there will be the halfway mark. We don't want to encroach with this past this point. I should probably hold my palette. Give me one moment. Yeah. This will save me reaching across. Use the same brush, but mix a darker shade of this to get a little bit of foreground and midground this base color. Because it will be adjusted. To create a sense of depth. Just make sure we get those corners. Edge bits just nicely covered there. use this to make some clouds, and possibly use the very point of this to perhaps do a few little birds flying in the distance. But we shall see what looks best and what just feels. One just very light little wisps just like that. Over the top, just to blend it out so it flows and fades. Cloud there, and a little cloud. Just that light pressure. Chiseled point there, if you can see that, just there, so that very fine point, just do something nice and dark and just get that little, let's have a little bird flying just there. Separate as this will be my clean blending brush. And let's create some details in the foreground. Let's do the these edges. bring this down to the bottom as well, Nick and Meat. That feels right for this. Just slightly encroach on that skyline. We will bring some trees up in the very foreground and some on this horizon line as well. Just don't want this to be too heavy. We want to set it back just a little bit. Excellent. Oops. Take that. Okay. Now, with the fan brush, just to use that. On, I think, this side. I think it should be here. And just tap it down, very light pressure at the top, so it and gently applying more pressure so it fans out and gives a good shape to the tree. And let's take something a little bit darker here for some shadows, and just below the points where it was previously tapped, and just follow that pattern. Just like that. Get something a little bit lighter. And very subtle little tiny bits of the highlights and the angle for where the light is coming, and we haven't yet determined that, so this tree will side the main source of light, which will be from here across, just like that. Little slices. So all of our highlights will be on this side, down and across. And in fact, let's just as we have this on this little bit of the foreground that I did, let's just have a few little taps, just at the top there. Those little highlights. It's very good to slice. Now we need to take this darker color. In fact, let's make it a little bit darker. hear the scent of the train. Now, just go down and just tap it, because when you see a tree, you can see the trunk, but you can't see all of it because of the foliage in the way. The idea that there is a trunk to the tree. Now, I will take this, I think. Yes, let's have another tree that's just coming over in like that. Frame this quite nicely. So we do as before, just taps, slowly bringing in a little bit more of the brush each time. So the tree grows to be a little bit bigger. Now let's get those shadows underneath. Just like that. And just get rid of that. And take our highlights. Now it'll just be tiny bits on this very edge. Just a little bit, just there. The light just about catches it. Just like that. Now, back to this brush here. So we can put that tree trunk in. Slice straight down, just like that, and then slice, and then the little dabs as we go down, perfect. To overwork it. Now let's go for something a little bit lighter than that previous tree, and we cut out just some little distant trees just in the center. They won't be as big as the two on the sides there, framing the it's just highlights on those sides. In fact, let me just take my very clean soft brush and just soften that. So it doesn't look too intrusive. It's like that. And I think I want one more jazz. really make those highlights pop. That's tree, the second tree, and the third tree. Just like that. Very foreground here, I want a little fence that just goes across. Take a, want a nice dark color, but make it something a little bit different from the tree trunk. Personality then, just slices across. Get that brush nice and sharp on the tip. Just slice that, and let's have fence post there. A fence post there. One there. Little highlight on that, and then just a touch of shadow below, as that sunlight is quite high in the day, not quite a midday sun, but a late morning sun, and so you know, just so that be seen just there on the braces there, and then let's take the shadow and just underneath and on my right hand side. And that is a very nice little painting of our sky with our happy clouds, two little birds there, the two trees to frame the image, the three little trees in the distance, and our little fence. You enjoyed today's session. I do hope you are taking care. And I hope to see you sometime soon.